Hello guitaristas, my name is Adina and you are watching the Spanish Guitar Hub, and today we are going to learn the rasgueado technique, and after this lesson you can play something like this. By the way guys, I have a guitar course which is called Spanish Guitar Strumming Techniques, and it has very similar lessons to this one, and it is available on Amazon or on my website, so please go to the link under this video and then you can attend to my course. Also, the tab is available on my Patreon campaign, so please go to my Patreon campaign if you would like to learn this lesson with the tab. So the technique is basically using the index finger and you are flicking, which means that you start from the bottom of the thumb and then you flick and flick, and you need to go back to the bottom and you flick. Also, you place your thumb on the E string and you are not pushing it down, just place it there, and after you try to hit the bass notes, especially trying to hit the A string. How you can see that you hit the A string, you just need to look at the strings and you will see the A string buzzing if you were able to hit it with your flick. Also, try to aim to have this kind of bassy sound, so don't hit all of the strings, try to hit the top of the string so you will sound better. So then when you go flick, and then you go back to the bottom, click, back to the bottom. It is very important to go back to the bottom, because if you don't go back to the bottom, you don't have enough power to make it sound quite nice. So go back to the bottom always when you do this technique. Also, when you go up, then you use mainly the higher strings. So that's why when you play this technique, you have this kind of bass sound, high sound, bass, high sound. There are a few other things which can be nice to pay attention to. For example, don't go too far away from the guitar, but be close to the strings, and when you end up on the string, you are still curved and then you are ready to go back to the bottom of the string. Now, to demonstrate this technique, I used the flamenco style called farruca, because farruca is in 4-4, so it's quite easy to make variations with this technique on the farruca. The chords are E7, A minor, E7, A minor, D minor, A minor, E7, A minor. And then I just added some variations. So to practice this technique, you can just practice it on a way that whenever you are in the E7 chord, you just go down. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. And then on the A minor chord, then you can do down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So it will be down, 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 up. Now you can do few things to make it sound a little bit nicer. For example, you can add a golpe. Golpe means that you use your ring finger and you add the hit on the guitar. Now, some of the guitar wood can be quite sensitive. I'm using a golpeador, which is like a cover for my guitar, so then I'm not adding holes when I'm doing this quite a lot. In my previous guitar, I actually didn't have this cover, and in the end, I almost had holes. I mean, it didn't change the sounds, but it's nice to have some kind of cover, so you are protecting your guitar. This movement is a little bit unnatural because your index finger and ring finger is moving to different directions. So while you flick with the index finger, your ring finger is going backwards. You need to have also a little bit of nail. If you have too big nails, you can lose your nails doing this kind of technique. But if you don't have a nail, then you won't have a very, very nice sound. So with nails, it's like this. Without nails, it's a little bit harder to make the right sound with this. Okay, so now let's practice this one. We will go down, 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 and after we will add the golpe each time when we go down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. You can make other variations as well, so it will sound even better when we do that one. For example, we can add flavors to each of the chords, so then when we play an E7 chord, we can add with, and when we play A minor chord, or for the D minor. Of course, there are other bits and pieces that you can do. For example, you can add mutings. It is also called staccato. It means that you play a note, but you stop the sound. This is quite easy to do when you play a barre chord, but it's a little bit harder when you play open chords. Because when you play a barre chord, for example, playing an A minor chord, you can stop the sound just lifting up your left hand. You could see the difference in the sound. Although, when you play open chords, you need to use with your left hand some different fingers to do the mutings. So, this case, we can practice the mutings on the E7 chord and adding it with the little finger. We can also do the same with the ring finger using the same technique. It's a little bit harder for me, but everybody's hand is a tiny bit different, so you might find this a little bit easier than muting with the little finger. You can also practice this kind of technique using the A major chord, and I'm holding it in a flamenco way, which means that I'm holding two strings with the index finger and one string with the middle finger. So I have these two fingers, three, so I can use them to do other stuff. Now I'm going to mute it. So it is just adding a hit and then muting it or touching it with the little finger. And you can also do the same with the ring finger. So, and there is one more thing that you can do, which can make the sound nice, and it is adding a kind of hit and then going down. Basically, you do the same technique, but you are kind of doing it in the air, and you aim the hit onto the guitar wood above the strings. And then you can add a little bit, of string sound to your sound, and it can add some nice effects. So once you master this technique, then you can go through the three-stroke rasgueado, which is kind of like in the same theory like this one, so you need to flick, but at this time we are going to use three fingers to do that one, or we can use four fingers as well for the four stroke rasgueado, or three fingers for the four stroke rasgueado, but then we go back up with the index finger. So it will be flick, 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 always flicking from the ring middle index finger. Or four stroke. Or four stroke this way. Although I will do a separate video on this one, and then I will make a lot of exercises for you to master that kind of technique, but at first you need to go through this technique and master this one. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button or subscribe for more videos like this, because I'm uploading guitar videos every Sunday. So see you next Sunday with another guitar video. Hello guitaristas, my name is Adina and you are watching the Spanish Guitar Hub, and today I'm going to show you how to play the flamenco tremolo, and after this lesson you will learn something like this. Thank you.